all t-shirts were not created equal. This t-shirt represents two things that you should avoid, all right? Number one is stripes, all right? In my opinion, t-shirts, they look the best when they are solid in terms of color, right? It doesn't matter what color, but solid. Stripes, it just makes you look like a little kid. It's not as refined, and you really can't dress it up, right? Number two is, look how baggy, look how roomy, right? You wanna make sure when you're wearing a t-shirt that it fits your body, which brings me to the next t-shirt that you shouldn't wear, and that is something that is oversized and too large. Even though I know that it's a trend and it looks good on like a few dudes, the majority of dudes that wear the oversized t-shirts basically look super skinny. It also doesn't accentuate your positive attributes. Now, that being said, the next t-shirt you should avoid is one that is too tight. This is an example of a t-shirt that is just too tight and small, right? Now, a few tricks, right? If you see a lot of pulling or whiskering, whether or not it's up on the chest or in the midsection, or if you can see your gut, that's bad, all right? If you lift your arms up, remember, if it goes like that and you can see your midsection like Britney Spears, the shirt is too small. The next t-shirt you should avoid is athletic t-shirts. And what I mean by that is sport t-shirts worn casually, all right? All right, this is an example of a Nike shirt, right? And in my opinion, there is a time and a place for this. Like, if you want to wear this to, like, work out, that's fine. But in terms of going out, like, on a date or going out, like, casually and socially, I think this looks a little bit too casual, all right? All of the sports shirts that are super shiny, super tight, they definitely should be avoided. In my opinion, graphics and logos are also something that you should avoid, unless it's very small, very minimal. But in my opinion, if you're looking to dress up a t-shirt, right, you want to make sure it has zero logos on it, right? You want to make sure that it's a clean front. Now, in terms of pocket or no pocket, it's really personal preference. But in my opinion, the clean, no pocket t-shirt is going to be more versatile because you can literally toss it on underneath of a suit, right? Maybe tuck that t-shirt in for a great upscale, elevated, casual suit look. Guys, I'm telling you, if you're wearing the right t-shirt, you can wear it seamlessly with shorts, with jeans, with khakis, but also under a suit as a base layer. In terms of the color, that's something else I want to talk about. In my opinion, white and black, those two colors are your must-haves, right? Because white matches with everything. Black, you can wear it with a lot of things, look more dangerous, dark, and mysterious. All right, the one thing you got to worry about, though, is the white shirts. If it starts to get discolored or yellow pits, you got to get rid of it, all right? One of the things and reasons why that happens is that the antiperspirant deodorant that we're actually wearing gets out and it stains the white shirts. And so if you're wearing white, you just got to make sure that you inspect the pits or switch to a higher quality natural deodorant. But what doesn't look amazing is anything possibly potentially offensive, right? Even if you think it's funny, even if you think, oh, it's awesome and ha 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 ha, if other people look at you and they see something that's offensive, whether or not it's a graphic, a word, or like pot leaves or like whatever, it's definitely something you need to avoid. It makes you look low class, low budget, and like a loser, in my opinion. In conclusion, gentlemen, t-shirts, a must have for every stylish dude. All right, they work incredibly well. You can dress them up, you can dress them down, you can wear them with shorts, you can wear them with chinos, you can wear them with a suit if you wear the proper t-shirt, all right?